United States dollars. This is going to be very challenging, but I'm convinced that with the assistance of my friendly government and institution, this can be achieved before the end of my tenure. Honorable ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to address you on what I consider to be my most urgent and imperative agenda. Since the founding of this country in 1847, more than 170 years ago, there have been certain restrictions on citizenship and property ownership that, in my view, have become serious impediments to the development and progress of the country. These restrictions include the limitation of citizens only to be black people, the limitation of property ownership exclusively to citizens, and the non-alliance of dual citizenship. The framework of the 1847 Constitution may have every reason and justification to include these restrictions in that historic document in their own words, and I quote, "The great object of forming these colonies being to provide home for the despaired and oppressed children of Africa and to regenerate and enlighten this benighted continent. None but persons of color shall be admitted to citizenship in this republic." Unquote. They are free slaves for fleeing from the oppressive yoke of slavery imposed upon them by white owners, white slave owners. They therefore wanted Liberia to be a refuge and a haven for free men of color. And so they restricted citizenship only to black people. This may have been appropriate for the 19th century and for the threats and conditions that existed at that time. Century, I am of the view that these threats no longer exist, and that these conditions have changed. In these circumstances, it is my view that keeping such a clause in our constitution is unnecessary, racist, and inappropriate for the place that Liberia occupies today in the Committee of Nations. It also contradicts the very definition of Liberia, which is derived from the Latin word liber, meaning liberty. I believe that we should have nothing to fear from people of any other race becoming citizens of Liberia, once they conform to the requirements of our immigration and naturalization laws. They may be appropriately amended to address this new situation. In fact, we have everything to gain if we look in our region amongst the other member states of ECOWAS, especially our neighbors in La Côte d'Ivoire and Ghana. It will soon be observed that permitting people of other races to become citizens has not marginalized their indigenous. I believe that this is an enormous that should not have formed
that were into the 1986 Constitution.